Hi, my name is Florian. I'm application engineer for Advantech Europe, and today I want to show you how easy it is and how convenient to operate SUSIAccess console. We are going to start programs SUSIAccess. The first screen we will see is the main screen of SUSIAccess. Right now the two clients are red. I want to know why they are red with an exclamation mark. I just double click. I get the device details, and yes, the fan speed is zero. That's okay, because that's a fanless device. And you see you also have it on the table view. And the table view also will highlight the item which has the mail function, so you can scroll through it. All the others are okay. We have the time from the last log. We have the status of the device. The monitor log will have all the mail functions we had. You just can go through all these mail functions and you can check, for example, the log time. When was this mail function? When did it occur the first time? You have it for the Advantech HQ PC. You can also check for the other PC. Let's go to the settings page. You can set what you want to monitor. For example, the system temperature is going up, going over 20 degrees. We set the system temperature low with 10 degrees, warning at 20 degrees and high at 41. If you're going back to the graphic view, one system has a warning, one system has a malfunction. So we are first checking the red system with the exclamation mark. Oh, the system temperature is over 44 degrees. Now we're checking the other one, who has just a warning. Okay, so system temperature is over 40 degrees. The next main function we have at SUSIAccess is remote configuration. Here we will see the IP address of the device. We will see the module name, the brewery, and the Advantech headquarter is this device. You can see it's an UTC 520D. What you can do, you can switch off the volume or turn on the volume. You can set a fan speed, or you can change the CPU performance. The another is file transfer. You can upload a file to the device. For example, you could upload a driver or a new driver to the device and execute it. You have a display control, which allows you to actively control the display. For example, if I set the brightness right now, it will change the brightness of my screen, or I can set it back. What I have here is the screen capture. I can capture a screen. The screen capture will work always. I double click, I just get the picture. Or I can also open a remote desktop session on the other device. And last but not least, we have also the event log, which allows you to check the events on your device. You will get this window. This window shows you all the information. You can scroll that through. You can check if there is something wrong. The next main tab is the system recovery. If you are clicking on system recovery, you can choose which device you want to have. You can start a backup of the device, or you can restore the device. If I have a backup, I would see here all the backups with the date of the backups, the time of the when the backup was done, and also a short description you can enter, like the last button is the administrator button. So first I want to change here the monitor, the background picture. So I'm selecting a new picture. I go to upload and I have a new background image. So I want to rearrange my things. For example, I have the tank here, and I also want to change the headquarter PC. So you can upload which image you ever want. You can draw your own image. You can draw an image from your facilities. So I have now this group. You see also the group name and the description. So I want to move now the headquarter device into the group headquarter. So I only have this group. Move it. Yes, I'm sure. So now I have headquarter group. I want to add another group. So I have now another group called brewery. What you can do, you can modify the groups. So if the description is not accurate or if the name want to be changed, the next tab in administrative is mail configuration. So here it's the mail configuration. You can set up to get emails. You need to have an SMTP server, which you can fill in here, and you can choose if you want to get an email, if the device is going offline, if it is going online, or if there is one abnormal setting. You can also define how you want and just click to submit, and you will get these emails automatically. I'm going now to disconnect the brewery tank manually, just to show you what will happen, so give me a short moment. I disconnected the device manually, and you will see it's now a gray box around it, which says the device is not available. If we check here, we have dead, no status log, so it's removed. We can also see it in the table view. It is gray, which means it has no data it can receive. If we reconnect the device, just give me a moment. So the device is dead. If we reconnect the device will turn into available again. And you see it's now available again. So, okay, that's it. That's SUSIAccess. I recommend you go to our homepage, register yourself and get your free copy of SUSIAccess. Try it. If you have any problems, contact your local field application engineer from Advantech and have fun with SUSIAccess. Thank you for watching.